This air shaft will provide access to the generator's control terminal.
Alright, I'm back. Welcome back to Doom Eternal. I have 5 rockets left. Got through that section finally. The cure seems to be to turn the camera off for a while.
The generator is now at full power. You can now use the main console to destroy the heart.
Excuse me, it's a little bit late. Shower and go to bed after this.
The generator is overloading. I have marked your exit portal.
Oh shit, I gotta get out of here.
Warning. Main generator overload. I repeat, main generator overload. Please proceed to the nearest emergency exit.
Great, I have no other weapons. Out of here.
Facility will self-destruct shortly. Please save your work and walk calmly to the nearest exit.
I hate my life. I hate everything about it. This long to get this game. I'm not gonna turn down the difficulty. I'm gonna beat it on, you know, a regular hard difficulty, not the weird shit. You know what I mean? I'm not doing that crazy shit. All that weird, dumb one life run, and like the old school. You know, find extra lives thing. Imagine playing this difficulty on extra lives.
The final hell priest location remains unknown. The demonic consumption of Earth will not be stopped until the last priest and his guardian are destroyed. We will require assistance in order to locate the final hell priest. I believe Dr. Hayden can help us with our search. I will calibrate the portal to the Ark's command station.
What do you mean? Oh, hey. Mobile turret, energy shield. I'm not gonna turn into a turret. I don't wanna sit in one spot. I don't wanna get smacked around. Oh Shit, if I knew these were down here, I would have saved those fucking points. So I've been reading some of the codexes, and the story doesn't really add up from the last game, because, like, some of the weapons are talking about, like, how they were of Sentinel design. What? I'm completely thrown off by that. I don't know how to respond to that.
This is the Resistance Network. In an unbelievable turn of events, the Supergore Nest has been destroyed. Reports from ARC personnel in the field say that they have seen a significant decrease in demonic activity across the globe. Many believe this is proof that the Doomslayer himself has in fact joined the Resistance effort and has successfully eliminated key figures within the ranks of the challenged. Operatives working inside the UAC cultist organization claim that the leader of that division, priest Dayag Ranok, was in fact removed from his office recently by the Slayer himself. As key leadership within the Mortally Challenge continue to fall, we are seeing a decreased threat from the demons on all fronts. This has given the Resistance a key advantage in the war for Earth. The UAC continues to deny any knowledge of his existence. As surviving members of the ARC network, it is the belief of this station that these reports are in fact true. We believe the Slayer has joined us in the battle against the demons. To anyone still listening to this broadcast, know that there is hope, and he is out there.
That's nice. Samuel Hayden. I actually do have a quick question. What exactly did he do to us at the end of the game? Leader of the human resistance on Earth. Dr. Samuel Hayden is the leader of the human resistance. He's a leader of ARC. Well, okay, I guess he was only trying to benefit humanity with Argent energy.
Dr. Hayden is just across the complex. This industrial campus was once the headquarters of the resistance.
Once? Oh, shit. Holy crap.
Good news for the faithful.
The deceiver, Samuel Hayden, has fallen. The Ark is no more.
He's dead? What the fuck is going on?
This area is no longer secure. Evacuation protocol is in effect.
Oh, awesome. I was wondering when that was going to happen.
longer secure. Evacuation protocol is in effect.
Where that explosion came from, but okay. The fuck is going on around here?
The Ark's headquarters is under attack.
You guys just had to get attacked right now, didn't you?
Beyond the pain, there is enlightenment.
How are none of these guys alive? Okay, you know what? I'm fucking sick of that. Alright. On fire. I'm shotgunning him at point blank range. He's not even close to death.
Thank you.
I didn't jump. Equipment I have, how much ammo I have, the amount of health or armor you get. It's just fucking. I get killed by everything. Okay, why the fuck is it making me automatically pick the rocket launcher? Great. Fuck me.
Into Dr. Hayden's outpost is blocked. Two peripheral turrets identified. Calculating optimal firing path. Confirm. You could use both turrets to clear a path. I will mark them for you.
Okay, no. No, I'm fucking tired of this stupid fucking bullshit. Never follows his own fucking rules. Tells you how to do something, but you try to do it, it doesn't fucking work. What the fuck? You weren't there! Why? Why was my turning so fucking slow? Why was he not fucking staggered? People suck! Kidding me. well. This game does frustrate me a lot, but I do love it. You know, it's the same thing with the last one. It's frustrating. But I love it.
Log entry 002. Subject analysis of Doomslayer, January 24th, 2163. There is no chance that the subject is a demon. We have blood samples pulled from the Mars base event that show his blood type is AB positive. He is male with a genome that makes him very much a member of the human race. But the enhanced strength, speed, and athleticism would indicate otherwise. But we can see from the blood samples that there are foreign bodies present of unknown origin. I cannot, as a contributing member of the scientific community, agree with the assumption by some of my colleagues that he is, for lack of a better word, a god, an avenging angel, the right hand of doom here to save humanity from its sins. But I cannot ignore that the timing of his arrival, the identity of his enemies, the fire and brimstone element to this catastrophe we currently find ourselves in has... It has definitely shaken my scientific resolve.
Huh. So, he is indeed a human. Understand why people would think that, you know, the Slayer is a demon or a god. Humans don't usually move and attack this well.
Thank you.
This is Dr. Elena Richardson, log entry 005, subject analysis of Doomslayer, February 2nd, 2163. Maybe he is a god. Maybe he represents humankind's rage, their will to persevere, to overcome that which would threaten our survival. He is uncompromising, a relentless being of violence that knows no mention of the hesitation shown by our many leaders and politicians during our time of judgment. Can he overcome them alone? If he can't, we as a species, all species, will not survive.
Why am I this strong?
Is born a sinner. You have to work hard to achieve success. Evolution is our destination. When they arrive, we arrive. No one is born a sinner. You have to work hard to achieve success.
What the? Why? That was fucking cool. I wonder where I keep all these weapons. Wait, never mind, I don't know the answer to that. I was gonna ask what? Where I keep all the toys. Movement control while in there, I guess so. Rage, baby. kicking their ass. Oh shit. Oh no. That was scary as fuck. pilot this thing?
Destroyed. The second turret will give you the angle needed to destroy the remaining tentacle.
I have to do that in the next episode. Thank you for watching. See you on the next one.